Hi there, welcome to the UXF channel, and welcome to this very different video where I'm trying some different things. I have my GoPro here that's recording my iPad as I'm working on it. I'm recording myself, and I'm recording my iPad screen all at the same time to talk about Dorico. And this video is going to be about Dorico on the iPad, something that I've had for quite a while and haven't reviewed and needed to review. And I'm going to post this video both on the UXF channel and the Tech and Music Ed website. And I'm not going to go through the whole process, but I really like Dorico. I'm much faster in Notion on the iPad for what I do. And I need to explain some things. When I was a high school and middle school choir director, I needed to take choral scores and put them into a notation program, partially so I could actually have accompaniment, because our schools wouldn't pay necessarily for an accompanist all the time, maybe for a concert, especially at the high school level, but not on a daily basis. And not only am I not a great piano player, but also choir directors get stuck behind a piano instead of being able to be out and about. So putting stuff into notation software and the playback capabilities that exist today really changes that for people. So my needs have changed. As an elementary music educator, I don't have to make choral scores very often. Our choir only meets for part of the year as an extracurricular at the elementary level, but I do teach ukulele and I create ukulele resources. So I need programs that can create ukulele, especially ukulele tablature, for some of the projects that I do. And that's what I'm working on here. Now, by the way, the background behind me, I'm upstairs in our kitchen where I do most of our work. I'm having my morning cup of coffee. Uke Republic from Georgia near Atlanta. So this is where I do most of my work when I'm working on composition and so forth. It keeps me upstairs near my family and it allows me to work in the thick of things. And then of course, when it's time to eat, I've got to clean everything off the table and so forth. But so if you notice that the background is a little different and the lighting is not great, that's all just fine because again, the main purpose is to show Dorico today and what I'm gonna do. And Dorico, just a little bit about Dorico. Long time ago, several years ago, Avid, which owns Sibelius, decided they were gonna dump the entire production team. The entire production team basically was picked up by Steinberg and they created a music notation program from scratch. Now, I do want it made clear that I am not an expert with Dorico. I'm a very fluid user with Finale. I'm a very fluid user with Notion. I don't think I would say I'm an expert with either. Compared to the average teacher, probably I am an expert, but in terms of the experts that exist out there, I'm not in either one of those. Sibelius, I never really got into, as I haven't with MuseScore, because both of those kind of create from an existing measure. You have an existing measure and you fill in the beats, whereas Finale and Notion allow you to start from nothing and fill in the beats that way. So instead of replacing rests, you go the other way around. It turns out the Dorico kind of more follows that Sibelius trend in terms of you've got existing rests that you're filling in, but it makes a little more sense to me than does Sibelius or MuseScore for that matter. And yes, there are other programs out there like Noteflight and Flat. This isn't a video about those. And both of those programs, by the way, do have ukulele resources as well. However, for what I'm doing, I need ukulele resources. And it wasn't until like year two of Dorico that they added tablature and things. So what I'm gonna do is just really show you quickly. I'm gonna use the song, Oh, 4,000 Tongues to Sing right here. And I'll put that also in front of the camera here so you can see it there. And I'm gonna do it in its original key. And by the way, if you see any of my chord melodies, a chord melody is a special thing with ukulele that puts the melody of the instrument on the top string. So as you play a chord, you end on the top string. So for example, on the first note, you'd want a D. And then you're gonna want a G chord where you end on a G. And even though an ukulele is rantrant where it's higher, high G, middle C, E, A. So in other words, the G above middle C, E above middle C, A above middle C. Even though the ukulele is tuned generally that way, ultimately, when you're playing a chord melody and the last note is the highest note, you're playing everything with your thumb, the last note is the highest note that you hear, well, then it makes a lot of sense. So you can arrange basically sort of choral pieces using your ukulele and playing just chords rather than having to learn full out tablature and without just playing one note at a time, sort of like a standard instrument that can only play one note at a time, unlike a piano that, you know, you can play chords and all sorts of things. Now, can you go further than that in ukulele? Sure, but for many people, it's a great chord melody, is a great recreational way to start. So I'm just gonna show you how I've been using Dorico. And again, I'm not using Dorico to publish things right now, I'm still using Notion, but I've been getting to know Dorico better, and I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna do here. So I'm recording the screen, I'm gonna switch over to the screen here on the iPad, and I am actually going to create a new score. So let me go back to create new here. I guess we're ready to go. And for what I do, guitar with tablature is what I want to use. Now, I'm not creating for guitar, but that's okay. I'll show you that in just a second, but this is the easiest hack to get in there. Also, with Dorico, you're gonna want a keyboard attached. You can get to many of the functions just on the screen, but a keyboard is gonna make things a little bit easier. And no, I'm not a master of this program by any means yet. I can just basically do what I need to do. So I'm gonna put in the title here, 048,000, capital T there, tongues to sing. And then it's going to be Charles Wesley. Now I've got the background of Charles Wesley loaded here. And what I do is I cut and paste the information that I need for that. So having some trouble selecting in Dorico right now, but that's okay. Then I just move my cursor over to where I need it to be and fill in those dates and change those around a little bit so that it fits the style that I've been working with. And that's probably all I'm gonna do here. My key signature is gonna be in the key of G. My time signature is going to be in 3/4. I wanna start those off right. Guitar with tablature, and then we're good to go. And here is my entry format. I'm gonna change a couple of things around here. So I'm gonna go to setup. There are four modes with Dorico. There is setup, write, engrave, and play. I wanna be in setup, and I wanna open up the little guitar thing here, and I want to go to the dot, 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 change instrument to fretted instruments, and then switch down to ukulele, like that. And I'm gonna change that. And if you notice, now when I go to write, I'm now in a four-line tablature, string 4, string 2, and 1. And I'm ready to go. And then there's only one other thing I need to do to start getting ready to go here, which is to tell Dorico that there's a pickup measure. So 3/4 tells it that it's in 3/4. And I just double tapped on 3/4 to get that. A comma 1 tells it that there's a 1 beat pickup, and I press enter. So now I'm ready to start entering notes. I'm gonna go down here in the lower left to the little guitar shape, where I can select a fretted instrument to start putting in notes. And this is very useful to me as an ukulele player because then I can think using the ukulele as I'm going. So I'm not gonna do a lot here. I just wanna show you how this is working. Now, the other thing that I have to do is as I'm entering notes, Sibelius is going to show us what part of the beat we're in. You choose your note values here, and there are shortcuts on the keyboard as well that you can use. But I also click this button up here so I can enter a chord at one time. I had a little technical issue there. My GoPro was dying, so I have to have it plugged in. Now I can go back to where I was saying. So I've turned on this button right here that allows me to enter a chord at one time. And I usually compose with ukulele in hand at any moment. So let's do this. So I'm going to start looking at the original score, which I will just show right here. And this is just, again, what you can find on Wikipedia and so forth. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna start entering the notes I need to know. Now, I know I don't wanna start with a single D note, so I've got a quarter note selected. I'm in that mode. I'm in the right spot, moving cursors left and right, and then I'm gonna enter, for now, the D that I need there. Okay, then I'm gonna go to the next measure, and I'm gonna enter the next thing I need, which is gonna be eighth notes. And I don't need to play a chord on each of those, but I need to play most of the G chord here. So I'm gonna add the open fourth fret. I'm going to add the second fret of the third string, then the third fret of the second string. And when I play that, you're gonna hear this now. And then I'm gonna repeat that note right here. And that's that first part of that first measure. Now, I need the D chord with an A on top, and that would be a standard D chord. And these are both quarter notes, so I'm going to go second fret of the fourth string, second fret of the third string, second fret of the second string, and then an open fourth string. And I added one too many there, so I'm gonna hit the back button up here. So I've got too many, and now it's gonna sound like this. And now I can't see that last note there either. So let's double check what's going on here. Got something too much. That one has too many in there. Let's double try this one again just to make sure I'm good. Make sure I'm in note entry mode. There we go. And then I need to add that chord again and move to the right position marker. Like that. And there we go. So that's that first measure of 4,000 tongues to sing. And I could put in the whole song. I'm not going to do that whole thing. I just also wanted to show you some differences between the two. So I'm going to go back to the main screen here. And I'm going to use the song Jesus Paid It All here. I'm working on a hymns project is what I'm working on. I just want you to take a look at what this looks like. So finished. Here's Jesus Paid It All. All right, there's Jesus Paid It All on Dorico. And as I zoom in a little bit, you can see how it looks. And it doesn't print out this other stuff. When you're ready to go, it doesn't print any of that out. It just prints the basic, you know, what you see here. Now, I just want to compare this very quickly with Notion. Here is Jesus Paid It All. Now, I've done one other thing differently. I'm going to hide the entry, you know, ukulele fretboard there. But it's the same thing. I've added chords here just that players can start learning the chord shape, because this is the one that I'm going to print. And that's Jesus Paid It All and how it looks on Notion compared to how it looks on Dorico. So, you know, Dorico, here's how I would summarize it. Dorico is basically a desktop experience that actually generally benefits from having the full keyboard attached. There's going to be a steeper learning curve. It's a little bit harder to use. I don't think that's bad because you just have to learn it. I'm in the help all the time trying to figure out what to do, how do you put in, you know, how do you move the measures, how do you do all these other things. And again, you have four modes. You have setup, write, engrave, and play. Now, when you want to play it, it actually brings you to your traditional sort of like piano roll. And, you know, there's a lot of things you can do. Versus Notion, which is, you know, in this format, still has a lot of power, by the way, but it isn't going to end up giving you as many options with engraving and so forth. it is for me easier to get stuff in. And I think that would be true of most players. Now, what you can do is you can take what you write in Notion and bring it into Dorico, or what you write in Dorico and bring it into Notion. But there is one challenge here, which is the tablature gets lost between the two. So if you're working like I do on ukulele or guitar stuff, you're gonna get lost. One other thing about Notion is that it was really created, this most recent iteration, which is now in, you know, its sixth version or whatever. It was when Jim Boitnot bought and acquired Notion. It's now owned by Personas, but he was a guitar player that wanted a program that was friendly for guitar players to use, and it really is, and therefore that translates probably better to ukulele. However, anything Notion can do, Dorico can do as well, including adding fretboard shapes. Let me show you one other thing before we go here. I wanted to also show you The Lion Sleeps Tonight. And on The Lion Sleeps Tonight, again, this is copyrighted. Oh, it's not really copyrighted. The song itself is copyrighted, but the actual song comes from an African folk song, so let's hope that I can use this. But you can even add the custom chord shapes here, like with the F and the B flat showing, you know, the bar. Oh, I don't want to do that. Undo. There we go. The F and the B flat with the, there it is. Come on. There you go. The F and the B flat with the bar, so you can make the B flat chord. All right, so let's go to engrave mode really quickly. I just want to let you see what this sort of sounds like. So, ultimately, yeah, I do think Dorico is great. It's definitely worth having on the iPad. I find it's worth having this and Notion. I also have Symphony Pro on there. I also have StaffPad on there, although StaffPad doesn't do anything really for me as an ukulele player yet. Maybe it will at some point. But Dorico is amazingly powerful. You have a desktop class notation program on the iPad. Again, you'll want a keyboard, you'll want to learn the keystrokes, you'll want to take the time to learn the program. It's going to take you a little bit longer to get through the Notion, but I really do think that it's worth it. And if you are a music educator and you have an iPad, this should be on your tablet. It's very affordable per year. You get full, you know, use to a certain amount without having to subscribe to it or buy the lifetime purchase, which is a new thing recently. But the functionality that you get with all the tools and compared to the price of buying the desktop class for many programs is a bargain right there. And yeah, so that is my real quick look at Dorico for the iPad. Again, from the eyes of a music educator that really needs it to write ukulele stuff at this point in my life. And if it can do this stuff for ukulele, it can definitely do it for a standard instrument or choral, because it could do those things first. And if you want the most flexibility for how your score is going to look on the iPad, Dorico is where you want to go. Now, could you use an application like Notion or something like PlayScore or music scanner to scan in your notes and bring it into Dorico and then clean it up in Dorico, or export a music XML from your PC or your Mac from MuseScore or something like Noteflight or flat.io and pull it into Notion and then do the rest of your work here? The answer is absolutely yes. And of course, whatever you create here can be exported out, but like in the case of ukulele, what you export from Dorico isn't going to bring the tablature with you, and you're going to have to do cleanup there as well. So highly, highly recommend this program, and I am just barely scratching the surface here. You can go so much deeper, and there's so much more functionality that I don't even need to use right now. Professional level editing on the iPad, again, suggested with a keyboard. It really isn't optimized for an Apple Pencil like other programs like StaffPad that's designed for the input of the Apple Pencil. That doesn't mean that the Apple Pencil can't be used for it, but it means it isn't designed for it, which is a little different. All right, thanks for joining me here for this video. Just want to remind you, if you want to support the work on these channels, on the UX Stuff channel or the Tech and Music Ed channel, there are three things you can do. First of all, you can like this video. Second, you can subscribe to this channel. And third, you can always buy me a cup of coffee to say thank you for creating this content at buymeacoffee.com/UX Stuff. Also, on buymeacoffee.com, in the UX Stuff area, there are now some picks that you can sort of buy as a thank you. There is an arrangement of my chord melodies for Christmas. There's a video ukulele method. And now there's also some membership options there as well if you'd like to support the work that way. All right. Thanks so much for joining for this video. I hope you're having a great day. And I'll be back soon with some UX stuff and hopefully some tech and music ed stuff as well.